Assalamu alaikum, hello and namaste. Welcome to the episode 9 of the Limelight. Today on the hot seat we have a charismatic personality, Zeenath Tanveer. She and her family are the proud owners of Zulfus Accessories brand in UAE. Assalamu alaikum Zeenath.
Walaikum assalam.
How are you doing today?
Alhamdulillah, good.
It's lovely to have you on the show, dear.
Thank you. Pleasure is all mine.
You're welcome, dear. So, Zeenath, before we get into the inside story of Zulfus Accessories, I want you to give us a little glimpse of your personal life.
I am Indian. I belong to from Bombay, but married a Pakistani from Lahore. Okay, I have 3 kids, mashallah, 2 boys and a girl.
Mashallah, mashallah. May Allah keep your family healthy and happy. Ameen. Okay, I have seen Zulfus Accessories being exhibited in many of the exhibitions and events. So, now I'm curious to know the story behind how Zulfus came into its existence.
Actually, Zulfus has a very small story. This jewelry is basically from Thailand. It is daily use jewelry. It's like for people who are working, the working class and the economic class women. Plus, it is jewelry on the go. It is just like gold, but you are not wearing gold. We actually started this from home. It was just a personal thing what my husband bought for us to use. And my mom, being a supervisor in the school, she was wearing the jewelry like a model, actually showcasing it for us. And the trend of people asking about the jewelry started from there.
Okay, so basically your mom was the main promoter for Zulfus jewelry. It all started from her showing it to her colleagues and in the school. And they started demanding from where you got this and so beautiful and all that, right?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. That's really interesting.
What happens is, like, you know, teachers and working class women are the main people who require things to wear and change on daily basis. So my mom, being the supervisor, she could only be the best model for us, and she is still the best model for us for Zulfus Accessories. And she is actually the proud owner of Zulfus Accessories. Me and my sister both help out my mother.
No, that's really amazing. A mother, a supporter and a promoter. It's awesome.
Alhamdulillah.
Okay, you must have faced some challenges in this journey, right?
Definitely.
So, could you please tell us what challenges you faced?
The product, what we were showcasing, or we are still showcasing, is for the women on daily use. It's for like the children, school going children. The basic idea on this jewelry is that it's got a film coating. It's got a laminated film coating on top of the gold plating. So the plating is not touching your skin. So in this, what happens is that even if you are a sensitive skin to imitation jewelry, you are not getting any allergy. To make the people understand, that was the toughest job for us. Because it looks like normal imitation jewelry, but it's something between meditated and imitation jewelry.
Okay, now this is really important, because when you are wearing an artificial jewelry, and if you are sensitive to artificial, you start getting infection. But in this case, you are saying your jewelry with the gold coating, it has a thin layer of film around it, right? To protect.
Yes.
Getting in contact with the skin. So this is much more wearable and it is safer, I must say, for people who have sensitive skin.
Very true. My jewelry basically starts from newborn.
Okay.
Up to any age group going upwards. My grandmom wears my jewelry. Okay. She is the next biggest model of Zulfus. My grandmom, she, the only jewelry after that we have started Zarkash, my grandmom has in her ears and in her neck is Zarkash accessory.
Wow, totally amazing. MashaAllah.
Alhamdulillah. Because, you know, it is the confidence that when people see it on us, they believe it. And in the last span of 5 years, we have managed to convince people to even come and buy the 10 dirham earring. Our earrings basically cost from 10 dirham. Okay?
Okay.
When a new customer comes to us, we only tell them, okay, ma'am, you need to just try the 10 dirham earring. The next exhibition, wherever we are, you can source us out if you are satisfied with us. And that has been the biggest power for us, because people have come back to us when they have not got allergy.
Yeah, you're right. Main thing in a business when you're selling a product must be customer satisfaction. The customer is the king in the business.
Very true.
Okay, let me go to the next question. Habits which contribute to your success.
Actually speaking, being truthful about your product. That's what we have learned from our parents. We have never taken Zarkash accessories as a business, but we have taken it to the level of making more friends than customers. Today, Alhamdulillah, I can proudly say that people who are associated with Zarkash and who would know me or my sister or my mom as Zarkash accessories are more like friends to us than customers to us. But if I am standing in an exhibition and when I talk to my customers, the confidence that I build in the customer is that 10 dirham, that what they are going to spend on my product, they are going to value it for the coming n number of months without feeling bad that they have wasted their money.
Right. This is more important, because you have to sell your product with confidence. As you know, the product is good, then obviously the confidence will show up from the way you talk, the body language, and the customers will surely appreciate that and take it from you.
Definitely. You wouldn't believe it that even now that I do exhibitions, I have so many of the exhibitors themselves who have built confidence in Zarkash accessories. Even though I have friends who are working in jewelry, who are working in American diamonds, and who are working in, you know, artifact jewelry, they themselves have used my jewelry and they have given me a very positive, you know, reply and a very positive comment about my jewelry, which is a very successful, it doesn't matter if you have earned the money part of it, but you have earned the goodwill part of it.
Yes, you're right. I mean, it is kind of a happy moment, a proud moment.
Definitely.
Tell me about your biggest strength.
Biggest strength. There are two people whom we owe Zarkash accessories to. One is my husband, Tanveer, and one is my father. Without these two men in our lives, Zarkash accessories is not possible.
Wow. Well, I had always heard that behind a man's success, there's always a woman. But here, behind a woman's success, there is a man or two men, I can say.
Yes, definitely. Because it was because of my husband that Zarkash accessories came into form. It was because of him that we were introduced to Zarkash accessories. And it's my father who has constantly kept it going and alive, has been supportive, has helped us out in every possible manner to keep this show running.
The support of your husband, your father, and I can say the whole family who is supporting you. And Alhamdulillah, you know, MashaAllah, you are very lucky.
Alhamdulillah.
Okay. I have a question. Which is the most happiest moment or aha moment you experienced during the Zarkash accessories journey?
Zarkash accessories aha moment has always been the most satisfactory moment after the exhibition, where we realized that we have achieved our target. Because that's, and when people come up to us and they are wearing our stuff and they actually come and show it to us. See, we are wearing Zarkas. That's actually the most proudest moment for us. Like, even I'm from a Bori community. I'm from a Dowdy Bora community. And even in my mosque, you wouldn't believe it, people have acknowledged us as Zarkash accessories. Like, they would tell each other that they are the ones who own Zarkash, you know. Those are the moments that we really feel proud to love. Wow, you know, people have started acknowledging our product and acknowledging our brand, and we are associated as the brand. So that's the biggest moment for us.
Yes, definitely. It is considered now as a brand in artificial jewelry.
Yes, very much. Alhamdulillah. I just hope and I pray that it reaches new heights, because the height that we set, we reach that, then we would like to set newer heights for people. Because it's only that we feel so proud that, you know, we can bring to people that kind of jewelry which is in their budget. They do not have to spend over it, because we ourselves are from a very down to earth background. We do not like to spend our money on lavish jewelry where we know that, you know, it's just a waste. But the kind of affordable jewelry that we are promoting, we feel really proud when people are wearing it and they really look nice. Like, there are brides who come to us with their outfits being confident that, you know, we will be able to match something for them, or we will be able to guide them to a newer style. Those are the, you know, very big moments for us, that we being just a small name, we are being recognized.
Yeah, you're right. And nowadays people look for things which are more economical and durable, and which can be sustained for a longer time. And especially the jewelry which you're providing is good and doesn't give any side effects to the skin, and can be worn every day to office or to school or any function. It is a very good achievement.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, dear. Okay, now the most important thing, the most important segment I can say, is advice to our listeners.
As an entrepreneur, you just have to be confident about the product that you are selling. Be truthful about what you are selling. Even there is competition, I face a lot of competition. I face a lot of challenges. But times there are low moments, there are high moments. But stick to your ethics. Don't let the competition get to you. What you believe in and what is taught to you, keep that in mind. We are doing that. Trust me. It's like, touch wood, it's my parents' continuous guidance that we are very strong about our ethics. We are very strong about not lying to our customers about anything. If there are products which are not durable, we say they are not durable. Which are durable, we are very confident. We tell them, yes, ma'am, this is the right thing for you. The kind of skin texture people have, which is very important.
Right. This is amazing advice you have given. Where most of the time I've said, the people who are into business, once they have success, they want to reach higher success, and in a less time they start to manipulate the system. But that is not right. Your values, your ethics, and the meaning why you're selling the product and for whom, that matters a lot. And do it with sincerity, and of course the God will give you success.
Definitely. That's what my parents have taught us, and we, as both the sisters who run the show for Zarkash, we have kept up to our parents' upbringing. We are very truthful about our products, and alhamdulillah, probably that is the biggest key to our success.
Alhamdulillah. Zeenat, it was a pleasure to hear amazing things from you and the story about you as an entrepreneur and your family. I'm really honored to have you on the limelight today, Zeenat.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure being part of the show, and I hope that, you know, lots of people come to know about this. We've also tried our best, and we like people to know the difference between lots of things, because people don't still understand between quality and quantity.
Yes, you're right. That's why I want to promote people with good values. That's my aim, and inshallah, I will surely do it in future too.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And you're doing a really good job, dear.
Thank you so much. Listeners, if you like this interview, click on the like button of the Limelight page and also do comment, as comments are precious to us. If you want to get in touch with Zarkash Accessories, the details will be provided in the comment section or at the poster of the video. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.